there is always more with Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Listen to this verse, verse number 38 in Surah An-Nur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا. Listen to the verse. Allah will reward you and bless you with the best of what you've done. What is this verse talking about? Imagine your entire life, you're working to please Allah and you're praying many, many years. Of course, for all of us, we're going to have a lot of those prayers where we would wish we could have done it better. We could have concentrated more. We could have perfected all of the rituals and the movements of our salah. But then one day you experience that one prayer that literally comes once a year. It's perfect. You're concentrating from the beginning right to the end. You feel the salah. You feel confident in the prayer. And that's the prayer you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And immediately when it's done, you think to yourself, how I wish I could have salah like that every single day. This ayah, Allah tells us that as long as you and I remain sincere, we remain devoted, we remain consistent, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start the process of accountability with the best act of worship to Him, subhanallah. So that means that one prayer that you experienced, that you felt was your best, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts that prayer, that is going to be the starting point of how Allah will account to you and me, insha'Allah ta'ala. How magnificent is that? So that is why, to make this Ramadan meaningful, you really want to perfect even the things you've been doing your whole life. Don't take them for granted, because there could be just that one prayer, that one day of fast, that one act of righteousness that you do for Allah that's perfect. And that could be your starting point, subhanallah. Allah grading us on a curve. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be amongst those He addresses in this beautiful ayah. Allahumma ameen.